Yeah, good Ner Shabbos to everyone. Baruch Hashem. We're now up to Erev Shabbos Kodesh, Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av. And it's, you know, it's a double inyan of Erev Tisha B'Av. And we know that Erev Tisha B'Av usually is a day of Avelus. In the afternoon, we sit with the Sudas Avelus on Erev Tisha B'Av, the last Suda. This year, because Shabbos takes over everything. The Kedusha of Shabbos and the Einik Shabbos takes over that even though we're in Avelus, Rabbi Hashem wants us to be happy with Shabbos. We have to know Shabbos is Shabbos. And that's why our minig is that we don't change our bodim. We wear our regular bodim on Shabbos. We don't want to spoil our Shabbos. Tzaddikim, who were in a madrega, that when they wore big davelis, they were in a high madrega. They didn't feel, it didn't ruin their Shabbos. And the Shabbos was still oinik, but the biggest oinik for them was to be davelis, to be able to cry with Rabbi Shalom. But we're not in that madrega, so that's why we don't change our begot and we wear the regular big day Shabbos. So first, what we should do Shabbos, by keeping Shabbos properly, that's one of the, you know, like the Gemara brings down in Shabbos, one of the things that caused the Churban Beis Mikdash, that Shabbos was not kept properly. Not keeping properly means you talk about things that you shouldn't talk about Shabbos. You do things that you shouldn't do in Shabbos. You don't give the proper covet for Shabbos. You know, like some people in the afternoon, forget it's Shabbos, their Shabbos afternoon day, especially when people go on vacations, you know, Shabbos, they forget. You know, we have to remember Shabbos, is that's why the halacha is, And we sent it out, and that's a halacha that you can't put on your sneakers till Motzei Shabbos. Because on Shabbos, it's Shabbos. You have to wear big day Shabbos on Shabbos. You're not supposed to wear big day chol on Shabbos. It's supposed to only wear big day. So first we'll just go through some halachas. That today, Erev Shabbos, you're allowed to cut your nails today, the covered Shabbos. You could take a shower, but not sit in a hot bath or sit in a hot shower. You wash your hair with shampoo and hot water, and you're allowed to wash your face and hand and legs with hot water and soap. The rest of the body, you just wash with, you know, with lukewarm. You don't enjoy it. You don't stand under a shower and enjoy it. Those who go to mikveh every week, go to mikveh this week. You go to mikveh this week also. And you prepare for Shabbos. You prepare for Shabbos and on Shabbos, the halacha is that, you know, you do everything on Shabbos like you do every Shabbos, even though it's Erev Tisha B'Av, till the fast starts, you do everything, you eat and drink, the halacha is keep, keep. Gemara uses the term kesuda shleime b'shatoi. You're allowed to eat kesuda shleime b'shatoi. You could eat fleishiks for shalosh udas, and we have two minyanim for mincha, 2 o'clock at 6:30, and the fast starts at 8:56. And so before that, a person should try to eat things that will hydrate them. You know, eat grapes, cucumbers, melon, and drink, you know, grape juice. This year, we could drink grape juice Erev Tisha B'Av because of Shabbos. So grape juice and or apple juice or cranberry juice, any the juices which will hydrate us. Water alone is good, but it's not going to hydrate you for all Sunday. I mean, be careful, it's going to be 85 degrees on Sunday. So you should be careful to not to go outside too much and to be try to be hydrated. Someone who has to eat on Tisha B'Av has to make Abdullah before they eat. And with Abdullah consists of, you don't make Abdullah on grape juice and wine. You make Abdullah on one of the Khamar Medina, a juice, a coffee, tea, soda, something that's choshev for you, that's a Khamar Medina. And you make a shakel, and at night, those make Abdullah at night, say Boy Maresh and the Bracha B'Mavdo. So first, the halacha is like this, that right before the tainus, you know, one should eat all these things. And you could also take the tzomkal and all these things that are pills from the koilu that will help you fast. You're allowed to take it because it's just like it's not called achana, because it's not called refu either, because just preparing, helping you, it's something, it's like you eat energy to be able to fast. You're allowed to take these things as a supplement to be able to help you fast. And by 8:56, that's when the Taina starts. You stop eating and drinking. So you watch Rosh Hashanah. If you want, you don't have to binge then. You can still continue and sing Zmiris and binge a little later. But remember, you're not allowed to eat and drink anymore. And there's a minig in our family, and it's a Kabbalah that there's a segula to take 9 sips of water right before the fast. And that helps a person that he should be able to fast properly and not get thirsty and not get dehydrated. So that's a minig in our family. And since I said in Besmedesh many times, people told me that they did it and it helped them fast. So then it's 8:56 is when you stop eating and drinking, but it's not about the Shabbos yet. But Shabbos, the first 50 minutes after Shki is 9:46. So those who keep the first, and there's the Bein HaTam is 10:08, but the regular Zman is 9:46. So by 9:46, you say Baruch HaMavdil Mekodesh HaChoyl, and you change into Big Day Choyl. You take off your shoes then, and we special made it with that with davening. It's 10:15, that even those who keep many times should be able to drive to shul and come to shul. And it's better not to sit in Big Day Shabbos and Avelis. And then at night, the minig is that we take off the proichus and you sit down on low till Chatzos, which is 1:24 on Sunday. You sit low and you don't open all the lights, same thing in the house. You don't open the lights. I'm sleeping. It says you should try not to sleep as comfortable as you always sleep. You know, if you use 3 pillows, use 2 pillows, 1 pillow, and there's a minute to take a stone, put it underneath the pillow to remember the Avnei Makkaim that Yaakov Avinu took, which was a remes to the Golus. And then after Chatzos, the halacha is that after Chatzos, one could sit on a regular chair. But after Shalshudas, one could clean up the house. You don't have to leave all the, you know, that, you could take off, clean the table, take off the stuff from the table and put everything away. You shouldn't go do the dishes and do on Matzah Shabbos till Chatzos. Same thing, those who fold the talus, you shouldn't fold the talus till Chatzos. You know, you don't do things that Masiach Das from Abelis. You don't clean the house, till Chatzos. To show that you're not Masiach Das Mabelis Nalocha, you don't do any malocha, anything that takes time to do. You're allowed to open light, you're allowed to drive a car, but you don't do things that will take your mind off from the Churban Beis Hamikdash, because that's the mitzvah. The mitzvah is to know that we're missing something. Someone told me, you know, why are we fasting? We have to know we're missing the Beis Hamikdash. Without the Beis Hamikdash, we don't have the real Kedusha that we should have. We don't have the real Kabbonas that we have. Our tefillah is not so the way it's supposed to be. The davening learning is not the way it's supposed to be. And we're supposed to, and we're supposed to remember Shchinta Begelusa, the Rabbanu Shalom cries every second. And the crying of the Rabbanu Shalom, the Shlach Kodesh Mekzan, if we would know how much pain Rabbanu Shalom has that we're in Golus and that there's no Beis Hamikdash, we would never put a smile on our face. So you have to be Mabel in Yerushalayim. So some people, so Tul Chatzos, you don't go shmooze with people, you don't do things in the morning, you don't go over say good morning to people, you know, you show that you're in a velus, that you feel bad that there's no Beis Hamikdash. There's no Beis Hamikdash. After Chatzos, one could you put on talus and tefillin in the afternoon, and a woman could start preparing food for and could clean up the house a little, that you have to. But I mean, it is that we don't all the things that we do in the 3 weeks, we don't do till Chatzos of Monday, and that's a minig. It's not a halacha. It's a minig that what we do is we don't do laundry, we don't take haircuts, we don't listen to music, we don't eat meat and drink wine. The only wine you could drink is for Abdullah. Abdullah, even you don't have to give a child. And you mean smutza tishbab, which is going to be 9:45. Before you eat, you make Abdullah, and you make Abdullah. You don't say any kalush yossi. You just say by Pia Goffin and the bracha of Amavdo. The meaning is we do Kiddush Lavana on Matzah Tisha B'Av, because we're sure the Kiddush Lavana, you say David Melech Yisrael Chai V'Kayim. We're waiting for Mashiach. David says Mashiach is going to be born on Tisha B'Av. So we're waiting for Mashiach to come. So that's where you say Shalom Aleichem, and you wait that that's the time that you do kiddush. Some people want to eat first, but usually it's hard to get a minyan together. So our minyan is that you do kiddush lana right away, unless there's food in shul that we can make a kiddush. The halacha is matzah Shabbos. We don't make bayim samim, but bayim areish we do say. So havdalah, when you daven, we say havdalah and tefillah. You say atochan antonu. So that's really the havdalah that we yotze matzah Shabbos. Since we can't make havdalah alkois, bayim areish we do make matzah Shabbos. So in shul we always have havdalah candle. Those who don't come to shul, a woman doesn't, you make bayim areish at home to be in. But you don't make bayim samim. You just make bayim areish. And then the matzah tishba, we said we don't eat meat. There are hatayim for some people to do laundry if someone goes out of town or someone has to, they could do laundry already on matzah tishba. But look at chilat, the minig is that till chatzos we don't do everything. The Rebbeinu should help that we should all keep our halachas properly, keep the hilchos avelos properly, and then we'll be able to keep the halachas of simcha because Rebbeinu should help. Now, somebody called me before, somebody couldn't fast on, can't fast on Tishba. But I said, the Rabbi Shalom, that all of us shouldn't have to fast. You know, that the Rabbi Shalom, that the Tishba should be a Yontif for Klal Yisrael. And, you know, we went through enough this year. You know, Alak Vaymer wasn't Alak Vaymer. Shavuos never Klavos. Again, we had Tzoros. And, you know, and with the war in Eretz Yisrael, the Rabbi Shalom, this Tishba should become a different Tishba than all the years. It should be a Tishba of Yontif. Rabbi Shalom, that everyone, by keeping the Avelos and by keeping Shabbos properly and doing what the Rebbeinu wants properly while keeping all the halachas properly, to see the simcha. And we know that that's why after Chatzos, you know, like really the halachas, we don't say Tachlan on Tishba Parolai, because we know for sure it's going to be a Yontif. We have 100% B'tochim. And there's no Shaila that the Mashiach will come. There will be a simcha. That's why after Chatzos, we act b'simcha, we, you know, even though it's still in Tishba, we show that we have 100% betochem that we'll get out of this golus. We never should be despondent, never should feel that, you know, we'll never get out of it. It's not true. We will get out of it. We'll get out of the pandemic. We'll get out of everything. We want to hope that we should get out of this golus and see the gula b'mehir v'meinu. So all of you have a good Shabbos, have an easy fast, and the fast should be the last fast we have. And maybe in the middle of the fast, we'll be able to stop the fast. The BS of Mashiach will be made.